Okay, guys, so my model came in and I prepped her hair and I curled it, but her hair is really fine, so I am going to crimp the root part of her hair, and as you see, it's just the part that is right inside, and I'm crimping it just a little bit with the San Villa texture iron, and the wave is still there. I'm going to be creating an upside down braid, and it's just gonna look so cute, and you'll see why the texture in the hair is going to be very necessary when braiding an upside down braid. So I textured all of the root part in her hair. Notice the volume that you have? Okay, so the next step to do this look is, yes, you're gonna tell your customer, whip your hair down, all the way down. And you are going to do a really cool upside down braid on her. Also, I did an upside down braid right here. I actually pinched and pulled all of this, and then I stopped it right here on the crown, and I just did a messy bun, right? Then I went to this section and I did an upside down braid all the way down, and I just pinched and pulled. And I really like the way a braid makes the face frame like a bang, but it's really not a bang. And again, like I said, the more messy, the better. I'm just one of those people that likes to play with messy hair, and it's so easy to do. Okay, so this is our finished look, and you know how I like to adorn the updos with pink pewter, right? So I'm going to be using our new collection called the Dazzle Snap Clip. It's iridescent, and it's a really cool item to dress up your hair. So I am going to, you know, make it a little bit more edgier and sparkly. And let me go right there. I'm gonna do that right there. And I don't know, where should I do it? Here, here, here.